Now from Chicago, here's Mr. Steve Dahl, a disc jockey at WLUP-FM out there, and the man who single-handedly was responsible for a riot at Comiskey Park. You don't want to be known
no,
as a riot.
No, I'm ashamed of myself.
No, don't be. It's not you. It's the people who ran out on that field that should take the responsibility.
I took blame. As a matter of fact, I went home, and after the alleged riot, and I went back home to Los Angeles to my mom's house and had her spank me soundly for 2 weeks. And
you
I enjoyed
it too, right? Yeah,
I enjoyed it. And so did she. And she's now suing my father for divorce, and we're getting married in about 3 weeks, and I'm kind of proud to make the announcement here on the show.
What kind of people do I hate? I got this guy coming on here saying, you know, I got this guy over here. Why do you hate this? Why do you hate disco so much?
Well, I can't find a... Can I take this off?
Sure,
I feel silly sitting here.
It's the only reason we brought you here. So, you know, if you want to take it off...
Well, I do look good in uniform, and I know you like guys in uniform. And
that's right.
You know, my name, this is kind of
I'm gonna pass it on.
Coincidental. My real name is Spam, and I changed it to Steve Dahl. Yeah. And your name is Meatloaf, and of course that's not your real name, and you changed your real name to Meatloaf. It's kind of coincidental. Spam, see, that's a meat product, and it comes in a loaf.
You're on a roll.
It's a little smaller.
Yeah. Good, Steve. Let's talk about Chicago.
I thought about calling myself Turkey Frank for a while, and
changed
it to Steve Dahl. I hate disco because I can't find a white three-piece suit that fits me off the rack that hangs well. And you gotta have one of those.
Reason, that's exactly the same reason that I dislike disco.
And I'm allergic to gold jewelry.
Oh, see,
and I don't like pina coladas. I'm allergic to coconut. So what does it hold for me?
Probably nothing.
Nothing. I can't dance. One leg is shorter than the other.
He's had a worse childhood than me. One leg shorter than the other one.
Have you had lunch with Bill Paley recently?
No. I've had lunch with Bill Veeck recently, though.
Oh, the guy who runs the team out there in Chicago.
Yeah, he was pretty upset with me. And he beat me about the face, too, for a while. And he has a wooden leg. And that didn't...
Weren't you amazed that 50,000 people turned out to vent their venom on disco records that night?
Oh, yes. Yeah, we thought we'd probably get 20 or 30,000, actually.
Yeah.
And there were enough security people there to handle that many. But they were too crazed, and there were too many of them, and that's where the problems really occurred.
Well, listen, it's not...
Business was good that week, though.
Yeah.
They sold, like, 90,000.
Yeah, the record companies, they complain to me. They say, Steve, what are you doing? You're destroying the industry. I said, no, I'm not. They buy rock and roll records, and now they buy disco records, too, to blow them up. They love it. As a matter of fact, I have some here tonight. I thought we could... Would you like to break one with me? Can we do this?
You can do anything you want, Steve.
I got to...
No, I like staying alive.
No,
see, I can't help it. I like staying alive.
Oh,
come on.
No, you can't say that, so you can't like any of it.
No, I like staying alive.
You're going to hurt your rock and roll record sales.
No, I like staying alive. Staying alive.
The courage of your
tune.
Convictions. Remove that record from Meatloaf's hands and smash it into a million pieces.
All
go
right.
ahead, break it. Get it out of your system
these
now,
These guys
Steve.
Are friends of mine. You're in trouble. These guys are friends of mine.
You're in trouble.
The Village people, they're friends of mine. And I did, listen, her real name is Gaines. You know that? I did hair with her sister, Linda. I mean, how?
Wait a second. Hold it. Is that a brand new record? Hold it. This is $12.95. Come on.
I got a receipt here. I need to talk to somebody about this, too. Is this a production expense
that
I can get reimbursed for?
There are a lot of people who would like to have this record. We don't want to just break it into a million pieces.
There are kids in India that want Bee Gees records. I know. I've seen that.
I know
Sally Struthers talks about it. Please send your disco records to India. She
they trade them for food there.
I do it right on my head. It's very simple. It's just a... Yeah. And actually, you know, to get serious for a second so the entire country doesn't think I'm a raving idiot. My parents are watching tonight.
Really?
It's not so much the music that I dislike. It's actually the culture, and we're a rock and roll station, the Loop is, in Chicago.
It's true.
Hardcore rock and roll station, and it's actually quite intimidating to our audience, to myself, to most rock and rollers, because you have to look perfect, your hair has to be beautiful, and...
I did.
Would you like to do one?
No,
but you know,
can use the helmet. It doesn't hurt.
No, I don't.
Do you know what
like
Ted Nugent said? I saw Ted Nugent last Saturday. You know what he said about it? He said he was glad for disco because it kept him away from his concerts. These guys don't come close to me, boy. They stay away from me.
Well, it's actually gotten out of proportion, you know, because New York, the media centers, and Los Angeles are so into it now. And the trendy ad men go down to Studio 54 and
put on a dress and say, hi, let's have a good time. Sailor?
Pretend they're Margaret Trudeau. And
I did that once. It worked.
Yeah?
Yeah, I pretend I was
Kate
Smith.
That might have been me.
I went through Studio 54 saying,
God bless America.
You know, Ethel Merman has a disco album out now.
Yeah.
It's very interesting to hear Alexander's ragtime band disco.
Annie Get Your Gun disco, yeah. I got all
it's
that
good.
Stuff.
It's good stuff. But anyway, it's intimidating. We're just trying to put it back in perspective. It's not that important. I don't want to see Margaret Trudeau's face anymore on the cover of anything with her little see-through dress on, you know, or Ally McGraw and doesn't have a bra on, and I'm not interested, you know.
You know, they get time, you know. Ally McGraw and now Margaret Trudeau will have to get equal time over this.
He asked me to do that.
What, equal time?
To get them on.
Oh, okay.
What is insane coho lips?
Oh, that's drug inspired. You were talking about drugs. Let's talk about them. I don't experiment with them because I don't need to experiment anymore. I know exactly what I'm doing with them now. It's all taken care of. One of those. In Chicago, they have a street gang.
Several, yeah.
Called the Insane Unknowns, which I think is an interesting name for a Mexican street gang. You know, somehow in a cosmic flash, they thought, Insane Unknowns. Let's be that. And I took the insane from them, the coho from coho salmon in Lake Michigan, and lips because...
Everybody's got them.
Yeah, that too. And it means nothing, but we are the insane coho lips. That's the anti-disco army. That's what we call ourselves in Chicago.
Now, what is this thing you do with the helium? I bought you some helium tonight.
I know, I appreciate it.
All right, can you do that for me with the where you do the BGs?
Yeah, we have it down here, I think. Much like we could pass this around, and I swear, some guy right now at home, I swear they were passing a hookah around on the Tomorrow Show. What is going on?
I stopped doing that in 69, you know, after I opened to Hendrix. And I really did.
Yeah,
you
know. Spent all
me
day.
Me and Hendrix were backstage doing this stuff once, and we were really out there.
No fooling?
I'm kidding, Tom.
Oh, I never know with you.
Well, you get very lightheaded from this.
All right,
excuse me.
Okay.
Go ahead and give me some money.
Oh, yeah, that sounds good. Okay. I need a little bit more now. I just wanted to test it. Well, I'll do. You sure you would like to do?
Whoa.
I'm seeing God. And he looks like
you see Meatloaf. Blue?
He looks like
you
Meatloaf.
See any blue? You
yeah,
see a little blue?
Looks like you. Sure,
62.
Well, you can tell by the way I use my wok, I'm a Chinese cook. What do you think?
No.
Listen, I'll blow.
Hey, let's get
away.
Some little finger sandwiches now. I'm real hungry. That makes me hungry. So that's what we do.
Is that it? That's the whole
thing.
That's
the end of it. You don't do the Bee Gees.
You know.
Well, that was the Bee Gees.
You can tell by the way I walk. I'm a Chinese cook. What's the second line?
Well, I don't know. I'll do more if you want.
No, but
I can't do too much at one time, because I'll pass out here.
That's okay.
That's okay.
No, I'm already.
The show's almost over.
You go down.
It'll be great. If you're going to go out on TV.
Exactly.
Man, I mean, go
Chicago.
Out. You know?
Hey, listen, let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
Do you want to go out on an FM station in Chicago? If you're going to go, pal, you might as well go on 175 big ones coast to coast.
You're right.
All right, here
right
we go. Showtime.
But I am in a lot of trouble in Chicago. They have a state fair there, Chicago Fest, like a state fair for Chicago. I walk in, I'm just enjoying myself, eating beef on a stick, you know, and walking around. And the police see me.
It's a corny dog.
Steve Dahl, and they came. No, it wasn't. It was teriyaki.
Oh, that stuff.
Steve Dahl, they came and kicked me out.
No, if it makes you funny, don't do it anymore. I don't want you to hurt yourself. I really
I'll
don't.
Do one more quick.
No, don't hurt yourself. Promise.
Let him do one
I'm
more.
I'm addicted to it, okay? I'm going to be honest with you. I've been off this stuff for 3 months. I do one thing.
It's all over, you know.
One time.
Well, that's it. Hey,
and I suppose you're going to sell me the second
luck,
tank,
you know,
right? You're going to sell me it for 15
hurry, minutes.
Hurry,
I got 5 seconds.
We're going to take it out of the street.
How deep is your love? How deep is your love? I really need to know. Give me a kiss.
Now these announcements for the NBC television stations, we will continue. Wow. Now don't ask me why. All right, here we go.
Oh, boy.
Well, we'll all be saying goodnight now for the NBC. We'll all be saying...
Really? Oh, you see a little boy.
I don't believe it. My thanks to Meatloaf. My thanks to Steve Dahl. Never
was to watch
for
Meatloaf.
Whoopee!
Right.
Whoopee. Thank you all for watching, and good night, everybody, from New York City.
While in New York, guests of the Tomorrow Show stayed at the elegant St. Moritz Hotel on Central Park South, near major corporate headquarters, Fifth Avenue Shopping, and the Theater District. Hotel accommodations furnished in exchange for this announcement.
Beginning this week, Primetime Sunday moves to Saturday. We'll feature a profile of power and sex novelist Harold Robbins. Join us for Primetime Saturday here on NBC.